Good morning, students. In our last class, we discussed about what are mixtures, pure substances, homogeneous mixtures, and heterogeneous mixtures. Yes, today's class, let us learn about how to separate the mixtures of solids with solids. Mixtures of solids with solids. In this, children, we have 6 techniques of separation. Okay. So why we have to separate the mixtures? Because the mixtures will be having, the components of mixtures will be having different properties. Okay. So for that purpose, we will be separating the components of the mixtures. So here in this mixtures of solids with solids, we have 6 methods. The first method is hand picking. The name itself says that we can separate the components of mixture by hand. So components of mixtures are of different colors, shape, size, and in a small quantity. If the components of mixtures are of different colors, shape, size, and if it is in small quantity, then we can use this method called as hand picking. So this generally we do when we go to market, children. So when we go to market and purchase different vegetables, as soon as you come home, you can see your mother just separating all the vegetables, right? So here it is nothing but hand picking. So we are picking it by the hand. Children, I just want to show this mixture. You can see this mixture very clearly, where I have taken the tur dal with some bambino, and this here you can see they are all of different colors, shape, and size. So can I separate this easily, children? Yes. So by using the hand picking method, I am separating the components of the mixtures. So I have separated this one, and even I can separate this one also. Yes, the bambino which I have mixed. So if it is in a small quantity and if it is of a different shape, size, and color, we use this method called as hand picking. Okay, children. So this is the first method, that is called as hand picking. Now coming to second one, threshing. Threshing is a method especially used by farmers to separate the grains from the stalk after harvesting. After getting the crop, they dry the crop, children. Okay, so that crop will be having the grains, a dried crop will be having the grains. So after getting the harvested crop, getting the stalk, stalk means the long ones what we have, what they do is they beat it. Okay, so they remove the grains from the stalk after harvesting. So that removing of grains from the stalk is done by threshers. So thresher is a machine where they are separating the grains from the stalk after harvesting the crop. So the process of cutting and gathering the crop, the process of cutting and gathering the crop is called as harvesting. And this harvesting and threshing, threshing means separating the grains. First, they have to cut the crop and they have to gather the crop. They should dry it. After drying it, that is nothing but called as harvesting. After drying, they separate the grains from the stalk. That is called as threshing. So this cutting and gathering crop is called as harvesting. Both harvesting and threshing is done by a machine, farm machine, which is called as combine. So combine is a farm machine which is doing both threshing and harvesting. So threshing is a method which is used by the farmers to separate grains from the stalks. Okay, children. Now coming to the third method, that is winnowing. So winnowing is a process of separating the lighter husk from the heavier grains. Lighter husk from heavier grains. After separating the grains, they get the husk. This I can show you like this, children, where your mother also, you might have observed your mother. See, these are the groundnuts, and the groundnuts what I have taken is having the outer layer. This outer layer is nothing but called as a husk. So now how can I remove the husk from this, children? How can I remove the husk? Just by raising it to the height and I will blow it. Just I'm rubbing it. Okay, and I will blow. So what did you observe? So when I just blow the air, so the husk is separated and the heavier ones will be falling down. So the same method is used after removing the grains from the stalk. So you can see that they will use one which is called, in Telugu we call it as chata, yes. So they put all those in that and they just blow it in the air. So when they blow it in the air, the lighter husk will get separated and the heavier grains will be falling down. So that method is called as winnowing. Okay, now coming to the next one, that is sieving. So sieving is a method where you separate the components of different sizes. Okay, in the construction sites, you can see children, sand. So they use a sieve. In our day-to-day life, we call this as a sieve. You might have observed, you might have seen your mother using this, right? So what she does this, she will be putting something in this, okay? And she starts sieving like this. So when she starts sieving like this, you can see that the powder, the small particles will be falling down and the heavier particles or little bigger particles will be left on the sieve. So this is called as a sieve, children. Okay, so in from the floor, they can separate the bigger particles and the smaller particles will be falling down. The same sieve is used even in the construction sites. So in the construction sites, they put the sand in that. The smooth sand, which is smaller, that will be falling down. They get separated and the pebbles or other particles which are present in that, that will be left on the sieve itself. So even dwellers and all, they use this method, sieve, where they separate the pearls of different sizes by using the sieve. Even in Kerala, cashew nuts of different sizes are also separated by using this sieve, children. So sieving is a method to separate the components of different sizes. Okay, children. So today's class, we discussed four methods, that is hand picking, threshing, winnowing and sieving. In our next class, we will discuss about the magnetic separation and sublimation, children. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.